So it's my birthday, and my boo, my hanging partner, and my boo back there, we about to eat, y'all. Guess how old I am? I'm in the new authority stage. That's what it's called. It's called the new authority stage. The big 4-3. What y'all think about that? Check out my hair. Look, reach out to Amina. Unique Amina. She does locks, y'all. Mine's growing. This is my second time having them done. It's been more than 6 weeks. More than 6 weeks since I had my hair done. We're about to go eat. Enjoy the fish and pig. Come check it out. Downtown Norfolk. Close to downtown Norfolk. Okay. Love y'all. Talk to you later. You gonna say bye, bitch? She waved bye. So this is how the inside looks, you guys. Check it out, check it out, check it out. Check it out. My baby girls, it's girls' time. Really nice atmosphere. Love the decor. Rustic feel. It's exposed ceiling. Yes, yes, yes.
Y'all,
it's
castrated.
Castrated, okay. Well, dinner was great, and while I had dinner with my girls, my daughter, Unique, started talking. I don't even know how the subject. It was what the food we were eating, and some of the food we were eating brings back memories pertaining to our culture and some of the things of how things were done back in the day with those who were slaves. And so my daughter started sharing a story. And from one story to the next story, y'all, I felt like I was in a history class with this young lady right here. Seriously, a full-blown history class. I had nothing to say. All I had to do was just sit there and listen. Okay? Now, I would like her... Can you tell them the history of the... Of concerning George Washington Carver, concerning the things. I mean, because I was talking about the creativity and the gifts he had, as far as, and he discovered the peanut and the different things of how to use a peanut. Because there's over, I believe, more than 100 ways that he found out a way that you can, what ways you can use a peanut. But she said, "Mommy, do you know that George Washington Carver was what, Nee?
Castrated.
He was castrated. And why did that happen to him? And matter of fact, what is that? Can you give the definition of what?
I hope I got the right word, but castrated is when someone's manly parts are taken off or removed. So basically, he was, I don't know if he was either adopted or he was, you know, basically a slave to these white people who had, you know, custody of him from a child. And also the white people that had custody of him, they had a white daughter, of course. And they were in fear that he would, you know, mate with his daughter, their daughter, and create a child. And they didn't want black children, so they castrated him, which caused him to have a feminine like voice and to never be able to have kids. And people thought that he was gay because he never he never would go towards women, or he would never pursue women, because of course he knew that he didn't have male parts. Those parts were taken from him at a young age. So all those great accomplishments, and that's what happened to him over his lifetime. And that's probably why he was so dedicated with his studies and figuring out what this peanut was, because he didn't have a regular life. He had probably a terrible life, being that he couldn't have love and all those, you know, crazy things. But yeah, that's about it.
Y'all hear that? I never knew that. And as you were talking, I was just sitting there thinking about some of the the things that are going on today, which is another modern day slavery for real, y'all, that's taking place, where a lot of people are, what is it called? Black what market? What did you tell? What?
Oregon harvesting.
I think you should look up the history on it and learn some things for yourself. But it's really true of people's bodies, people being killed and their organs being
Black
taken. Specifically, our culture. And the reason why, because our melanin is what?
Worth more than gold by 3 times, 4 times more.
Did y'all just hear that? Our melanin is worth more than gold. Look, and I'm not here to say all these things or bring all this up to cause controversy, but there's history about every culture here on this earth. But when you begin to learn the depths of where, you know, your culture and where you come from, it's a deep thing. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure if you went back in your history and learned some things about your culture for other people who have all different, because I'm sure people who watch my video, we all come from different walks of life. God created all of us. We can't judge people based off of some certain things that our ancestors did, but I know for now, for what's going on, it's time for us as people to crack down on negative things that are taking place. You know what I'm saying? And I just was amazed by some of the things that I learned from my own child, who's always been dedicated to history and knowing about things instead of looking at it at face value. Always, it's so important. The word of God says that people perish for a lack of knowledge. Literally, die, leave this earth prematurely because you're not willing to learn. Knowledge is important. So look, I encourage you to start looking up things, studying things through the word of God, through history books, just researching, going traveling, and willing to open your mind up to learn so that we can be able to help people, pray with people, and understand, right? So y'all be blessed. I truly enjoy my birthday. I'm about to get me some chocolate cake, y'all. Make it happen. It's time. It's time for a percolator. So I may come back before the night is over. Smooches. Okay, so I'm sure you just finished watching the main part of the video. I actually recorded that the day of my birthday. It's been a week since my birthday has passed, and I never uploaded that video, mainly because I've had a lot going on. You know, I still been celebrating, but I wanted to come back on the, you know, record and talk to you all a little bit more about the revelation that I received that night concerning George Washington Carver, and how it's really impacted my life personally. After learning some of those things that I learned that day with my daughter, you know, I had went to bed. I don't know if I went to bed and woke up or before I went to bed. Well, actually, before I went to bed, my little girl, Vision and I, we cuddled up in the bed together. She still likes to sleep with her mom, right? And we watched the documentary of George Washington Carver. And she was truly interested, y'all, in watching it. Number one, when she got home that night, guess what she did? She went in her Google on her phone and she started asking Google about George Washington Carver. That goes to show that our children, if you're willing to minister and pour into your children, they are like sponges. They want to learn. They want to understand. They want to grow. They want to know why, how, when, where. That's why it's so important, y'all, what you allow your children to receive, what they're hearing, what they're listening to. All of it has an effect on what they will be and ultimately become in the future. I don't want to get off on a tangent because y'all know I can go on one. But really what I wanted to say was I watched the rest of the documentary because actually after my daughter and I learned what we learned. Well, my daughters and I learned what we learned on that day of my birthday at the restaurant. I end up having a revelation that I had watched a documentary of George Washington Carver, but I didn't complete it. So I went back in my YouTube and found it. And it actually was still at the same place where I hadn't completed watching it. And that was actually last year, like towards the end of the year. I love watching documentaries, right? So I finished watching it. And one of the things that stood out to me that I want to share with you all was the people who were doing a documentary on George Washington Carver. They said that he was a professor, one, right? He was a professor at a couple of different colleges, right? Universities, colleges, or whatever you want to call it. And he really was dedicated, right, to what he did. You know, although he was castrated, although his manhood was taken from him as a child, y'all. One thing I want you to know before I go into sharing what I've learned on a documentary, something that God revealed to me was, Kawania, do you see that although something sacred that I blessed that man with was taken from him, how he did not give up on life and how he persevered and chose to still fulfill his purpose? Look, that right there, y'all, that inspired me more than life itself, that someone could have something as intimate taken from them that they could give, so that they could give life, you know, for a man and a woman to come together and give life, to have children and to have children's children's children. And he not have that, but he did not let his story end because of that. He put his focus and his gaze, his attention on his purpose and learning about this peanut and learning about the different things that he was called to learn about. And he accepted the call and accepted the journey and the challenges. When people called him and say, hey, I want you to come to this college and I want you to do this, he went, he accepted the call, he did it. He didn't lay down and die. How many of you all have given up on things that you shouldn't give up on, that you need to go and persevere and make it happen in? Look, I know I'm going to raise my hand and say, look, our story isn't over. I don't care how old you are. Hey, 43, 44, 45, 65, 25, whatever age it is, your story is not over. If God woke you up this morning, you still have a purpose. You still have a plan. There is still life in you. And there are still things that the Lord wants you to do, just like God used George Washington Carver. And I think about, if that happened to George Washington Carver, how many more slaves or different people experienced being castrated? Experience having certain things say or used as experimental devices. Look, I know all people went through things, but I can vouch for my skin that there's a history that's deep and wide. And I'm sure you can look at yours and say there's a history as well. But look, I'm just here to say to you that don't give up. Right? You have a purpose. Look, George Washington didn't give up. And I want to also say that in that video, they stated that when he was, what is the word I want to say, y'all? When he was grading his students' papers, you know, on the assignments that they had to do, he would always say, you know, he would end after he would grade it and give his opinion on what they did, if they did it right or did it wrong, and they got their grade, they got their score. He would say, from your father. Look, he considered these students that he taught as his children. Y'all hear me? A man that could not have children, a man that never loved. From my understanding, never loved, I guess, but put his all in his work, considered each and every student that he teached at the schools, he saw them as his own children. He was dedicated to seeing them fulfill their purpose. What are you dedicated about? What are you dedicated about? I'm asking you this because I'm also in my head. God has been talking to me about this week, right? And I'm a woman that's always have a plan, always just like bam, bam, bam. But lately, God has been speaking to me about, Kawana, I wanna put some fire underneath your feet. Because baby, your story, it ain't ended. It's really just beginning. I'm ready, y'all. Are y'all ready? Are you ready to do some great things here on this earth? Look, I don't want to keep this video long. I'm done because I see it's about 7 minutes now, and that's like expanding the video out. But I just want you to know that I truly enjoyed my birthday, and anyone else that had a birthday in this month, because this is actually the last day of June when I'm actually putting this video up. But I had a blessed birthday. That weekend I went away and enjoyed myself, you know, with someone special, and I just had a really good time, right? Just being a woman, having childlike faith, laughing, and just all the more. And maybe one day I might put that video up in the future. But look, enjoy life, okay? Live life with no regrets. Give your best at everything you do, right? Okay? Make a difference in this world like George Washington Carver did. Make a difference in this world like our Father, you know, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords have done. Like his son, Jesus Christ, who sacrificed and gave it all up for us. Make a difference. Look, you're on this earth and only you have your fingerprints. Make sure that your fingerprints impacts the world. Okay? Let's do this together. I love you all. God bless you. Blessings.